Hello everyone, I am Abusaid Chaudhry, a student from Leibniz University of Hanover. I'm studying Masters in Internet Technologies and Information Systems, and here is my partner.
I'm Mohammad Nizamuddin, and I'm also studying in the Leibniz University of Hanover in the same program. So we are doing a project this semester for wireless sensor network, and the title of our project is Smart Traffic Signal Control System Based on Traffic Density.
Let's have a closer look to our project in detail.
Here goes the scope of our project. We will have a single junction connected by several roads. The number of connecting roads can vary. It can be 3 or 4, which is configurable. Next, each road will have multiple lanes, which means the vehicles intended to go straight should follow the middle lane, and the vehicle intended to go left or right should follow the corresponding lane. In our application, we should be able to define a road length to measure the car density, which means how much of that road is occupied by vehicles. At the beginning of any road, there should be RFID scanners to scan the incoming vehicles. And also there should be RFID scanners at the end. End means when the vehicles passes through the signals. And in our given scope, all the vehicles have RFID installed. For example, in the city Dubai of United Arab Emirates, all vehicles are mandatory RFID installed. We have considered this scenario here. Signal timing should be calculated based on the vehicle density of a road. Let's take a look of a four-way junction. Here is an example of a junction connected with 4 roads, which we have used for this demonstration. As we can see, roads from north direction, from south, from east, and from west direction connected to a point. This connecting point is called junction. We can also see each road have 3 lanes for the vehicles intended to go left or to go straight or to go right. Each lane have a signal to control the vehicle's movement. Now I am going to discuss about the signal order we have considered in our application. We have considered 4 different signal combinations. The first combination, when signal turns on, all the vehicles from north to south and south to north will start passing. And also the vehicles from north to west and south to east will start passing too. The first passing we call it straight pass, and the second passing we call it right pass. Now the second pair, when the signal turns on, then all the vehicles from south to west and north to east will start passing. We call it left passing. The next one is the signal pair 3. When this turns on, then all the vehicles from east to west and vice versa will pass through. Also, the vehicles from east to north and west to south will be passing on. Now the last signal pair. When this turns on, then the vehicles from east to south and west to north will start passing. This is a very simplified class diagram of our application. Starting from the top left corner, this is the junction class, which has 4 members of road class. The junction class will control everything, such as it processes the request from the RFID scanners, it calculates the signal timing, commands the other members to do their job. The next one is the request object. In our application, we are receiving data from RFID scanners. This class parses the request raw data into meaningful request objects. Now let's jump to the road class. We have seen before that the road class is a member of junction class. It contains the length of the roads, a list of vehicles, and 3 signal classes. Those are represented as the left signal, straight signal, and the right signal. This class is responsible for adding or removing incoming and outgoing vehicles. It also computes the amount of length occupied by the vehicles on this road. Now moving to the car class. The car class has 2 members. The first one is the direction, which indicates the car intended to go. And the second one is the length of the car. This class also has a special method called fill by request object. What it does, it fills a car object by the... Let's move to the signal class. It only represents a signal enumerated member, that represent the different light states, which is green, yellow or red. The last class is the signal pair class. As I have discussed about four signal pairs before, the signal class has a member first pair and second pair, both are root classes. It also has signal interval time and the signal start time. The signal pair class has four childs. Every child is responsible for changing their own signal light state. In our project, we have a very simple configuration file. In the configuration file, we can define the default car length, default signal stay time, different lengths of the different roads, the request access port, and the average speed of a car. Now I am going to describe in short the processes we have followed so far. If a vehicle passes a beginning RFID scanner of a road, then it is being listed to a certain road. Also, the RFID scanners detect the intended direction of a car. And the vehicle length is also being detected. The controller measures how long of a road is occupied by vehicles and detect the maximum. The distance from the last car to the signal is also detected. Let's assume that the average speed of a vehicle after a signal turns on to cross the signal is 25 km/h, which is also equivalent to 6.944 m/s. If the last vehicle of a signal pair is 70 m far from the signal, then the signal time for this pair is time equal to distance by the velocity. In this case, the distance is 70 m and the velocity is 6.944 m/s. So the time is 10.8 seconds, which is approximately 10 seconds. If the signal time is less than the default signal time, then the default signal time will be applied.
So in this project, we used one Raspberry Pi here. We used two MFRC522 RFID module, and we used this breadboard to connect both of them with Raspberry Pi. We use this reader here, RFID module here, as an incoming car reader for the cars, and this module here as an outgoing reader for the cars. And you have those RFID tags considered as a car.
Now we are going to compile the C++ application, which is our server, and we are going to start this application because it starts listening to the port, and so that the client can send the information to the port. Now we are going to start our client application, which is written in Python and controls our hardware. It reads the car information and sends it to the server. In our configuration file, we have set 3 seconds for default signal switching interval. And we can see in the left window that the server application switches the signal every 3 seconds. Now we are going to simulate some incoming car requests through the RFID reader. In the right window, we can see the incoming car information, and in the left window, we can see the server handles those requests and the cars are populated in different roads. As a result, the default signaling time interval has changed according to the car density. Now we are going to simulate some outgoing requests through the hardware. In the right window, we can see the outgoing car request, and in the left window, we can see the number of cars are decreasing from different roads. Then, as so many outgoing car requests is generated, the number of cars are decreasing, and as a result, the signal switching interval is now switched back to the default signal switching interval, which is 3 seconds.
That's all, and thank you very much for being with us.
And if you have any question, please feel free to contact us. Thank you. Have a good day.